The lead up to the Battle of Benevento involved a complex series of events tied to the power struggle for the Kingdom of Sicily. After the death of Frederick II, Holy Roman Emperor, in 1250, the Kingdom of Sicily was left in a precarious state. Manfred, the illegitimate son of Frederick, seized control of the kingdom, despite Pope Innocent IV's efforts to install a papal regime. The conflict between Manfred and the papacy intensified, leading to Pope Urban IV offering the Sicilian crown to Charles of Anjou, brother of King Louis IX of France, in 1263. Charles accepted the offer and assembled an army to claim the throne, setting the stage for the battle. Manfred's infantry, including foot soldiers and Saracen archers, would have formed the front line. The infantry would be arrayed to engage the enemy's approaching forces, with archers positioned to provide range support, aiming to disrupt the enemy lines before the main engagement. The heavy cavalry, consisting of knights, would likely be positioned on the flanks. This placement would allow them to execute flanking maneuvers or charge the enemy's lines at a critical moment. The light cavalry, including the Saracens, would also be on the wings, ready to exploit openings or pursue retreating forces. A reserve force, possibly comprising a mix of infantry and cavalry, would be held back under Manfred's direct command. This reserve could be deployed to reinforce weak points, exploit breakthroughs, or cover a retreat. Charles's army, predominantly composed of heavy cavalry and supported by infantry and crossbowmen, would likely have adopted a formation emphasizing the strength of its knights. The infantry, along with crossbowmen, would form up behind the cavalry or on the flanks. The crossbowmen in particular would be tasked with providing covering fire, disrupting the enemy's approach, and engaging opposing archers. Additional cavalry units, potentially including allies from the Italian city-states, would be positioned on the flanks. These units would be key in executing flanking maneuvers or countering enemy cavalry attempting to do the same. Similar to Manfred's formation, Charles would maintain a reserve force, likely comprising both cavalry and infantry. This reserve would be crucial for reinforcing the battle line, exploiting successes, or securing the field in the event of a breakthrough. As dawn broke, both armies took their positions on the battlefield. Manfred positioned his forces to take advantage of the natural terrain, placing his troops behind the river Calore to create a defensive barrier. Charles of Anjou, aware of the need to engage Manfred's forces directly, initiated the battle by ordering his troops to cross the river, despite the inherent risks of attacking an entrenched position. Charles's forces approached the river, and despite being under missile fire from Manfred's crossbowmen, they managed to find a fordable section. The vanguard, composed of heavily armored knights, led the crossing. Once across, they formed up and began to press Manfred's skirmishers, who had been harassing the crossing with arrows and bolts. In response to Charles's successful crossing, Manfred deployed his cavalry, including his elite German knights and Saracen horsemen, to counter the advancing Angevin. The initial cavalry clashes were fierce, with both sides experiencing losses. Manfred sought to exploit his knowledge of the local terrain, attempting flanking maneuvers to disrupt Charles's lines and relieve pressure on his own troops engaged in the front. As the battle intensified, the infantry became engaged. Charles's foot soldiers, including his Italian allies, pressed forward, engaging Manfred's mercenaries. If you come this far, please like and subscribe. The combat was brutal and chaotic, with the outcome hanging in the balance. Charles, recognizing the critical moment, committed his reserve forces to the fray, seeking to break the deadlock. With the battle reaching its climax, Manfred made a bold decision to lead a desperate charge at the heart of Charles's forces, aiming to either break through and turn the tide, or die in the attempt. Clad in his royal armor and rallying his remaining knights, Manfred plunged into the enemy ranks. The charge led by Manfred initially caused confusion and disruption in Charles's lines. However, the Angevin forces, bolstered by their reserves and the personal leadership of Charles, managed to regroup and counterattack. The combat around Manfred became particularly fierce, and in the ensuing melee, Manfred was struck down. With the fall of Manfred, the morale of his troops collapsed. Realizing their king was dead and their position untenable, Manfred's forces began to disintegrate. Charles's troops capitalized on this, pressing their advantage and turning the retreat into a rout. The remaining Ghibelline forces were either slain, captured, or scattered, sealing the victory for Charles of Anjou. The Battle of Benevento was a masterclass in medieval warfare, showcasing the importance of leadership, morale, and the use of terrain. The tactical decisions made by both generals and the responses of their troops underscored the unpredictable nature of battle and the fine line between victory and defeat. The death of Manfred and the defeat of his forces marked a significant turning point. Charles of Anjou's victory at Benevento secured his control over the Kingdom of Sicily, establishing the Angevin dynasty in the region. This victory had a profound impact on the Guelph and Ghibelline dynamics, with the Guelphs gaining a substantial advantage. The battle also had broader implications for the political landscape of Italy, influencing the balance of power between the papacy, the Holy Roman Empire, and the various Italian city-states for years to come. The Battle of Benevento is remembered as a pivotal moment in the history of medieval Italy, illustrating the complex interplay of papal and imperial politics, the role of mercenary forces, and the shifting allegiances of the time. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you found our content helpful, please don't forget to hit the like button, as it really helps us out. For more videos, make sure to subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon so you're immediately notified of our new uploads. Next video, more battles, more history. Click to watch now. We'd love to hear your thoughts and suggestions, so please leave your comments below. See you in the next video. Take care.